Now, you've mentioned several different things. You could pick any of them to make personal statement topics or diversity statement topics. What I would encourage you to do, though, is not try to explain everything in each statement. There will inevitably be some things that are left out of your application altogether. Some of them might be covered in the resume, but some might not be. And so when you were describing the different experiences that you've had, I know you were just telling me your background, but I wouldn't want that to be how a statement read, because then you run the risk of a laundry list, simply listing everything that happened from start to finish. Some details will be left out. I think the idea of getting shot, that is, of course, a unique experience. And if you said that it was not in the statement, I might think about including that in some way, because that does speak to the gravity of the situation that you underwent. How does that strike you?
Oh, yeah. No, I do mention it, but I mention it more in the middle of the probably the second paragraph or third paragraph, somewhere along there. That's exactly where I was going with, because my diversity statement just seems like it's a laundry list, where my personal statement, it just seems like it's dead on right now. I really haven't shown it to anybody. I had one person read through, and then there was just some minor changes that they mentioned. So I made those corrections. But other than that, it's more like the diversity statement right now seems to be where it's like not coherent. And my personal statement just seems to be on point. But yeah, there was a lot of details that I left out just because it's limited to 2 pages, double space. And when I wrote it, well, I mean, there's a few schools that will take 3 pages, but I feel like less is more in this situation. So I just try to keep it as concise as possible. So I think I'm really close to being there on the personal statement. And then the diversity statement, that's where it's like, okay, what makes me diverse? I feel that there's like 20 different things that makes me unique. And it's like, how do I explain all of this in 2 pages without rambling on? And I'm not mentioning things that are on my resume, because I don't feel like, okay, me working at a bank and then working over here and working over there, that's really diversity. For me, it was more of my background, like being raised at a trailer park. Like a lot of people talk about growing up poor or whatever, but it's like I don't hear about anyone coming from a trailer park. And growing up, the only person I thought I knew that grew up from a trailer park was Kid Rock. And then years later, come find out he had like this 5-acre estate. It's like, okay, that was all a hoax. Like that guy never spent a day in a trailer, you know?
Thanks for tuning into the show. Please subscribe if you haven't done so already to be notified of new episodes as I release them. And feel free to reach out if you need anything at all as you move forward with your prep. I'm happy to help however I can. In the meantime, I wish you all the best and take care.